from St. Edward's High School Gymnasium.
From Tennessee, 62-0 today. Didn't give them a match. And then they beat Rock Hill, South Carolina, 49-13. So they're good.
All right, what about New Jersey? They've come in, what, 49 out of the last 52 meets? They've been victorious. How tough are they?
Well, Mike, they have a dual meet format in their state tournament, so you have to win with a team. And so their team is outstanding. They won this afternoon 55-5 over Tennessee and 51-14 over South Carolina. So they're very tough indeed. They're a great team.
All right, where are we going to have to look to see where the match will be decided? Middleweights?
I think so. I think most people expect New Jersey to jump out to a quick lead. First three weight classes, they've got to be the favorites. If they don't win there, they're in trouble, but I think they will.
Sports News, I'm Gary Short. Good night.
St. Ed's should be winning just about every. They should be favored in almost all of them, except perhaps at 185.
Yeah, I was going to say 185. It could be a toss-up.
That's right, and that may be an important toss-up because some of the matches where Eds are favored are going to be very slender favorites indeed. This team has a great dual meet team. They have just about an undefeated record for every one of their kids that are going to wrestle tonight, so they're really good.
All right, St. Edward's, five-time state champion. It is a record. They're ranked number one nationally. They've got their hands full tonight. They've won their quadrangular the first three times they've had it, except for the first one when they lost, and that was the year that they came on so very strong and started this great reign.
Well, they lost 2 years ago to Midwest City. That was a big defeat. I think it showed them how important this quadrangular really is. And so they're going all out tonight to beat Highland Regional, who I think may well be one of the top three or four teams in the country, too.
It's going to be an exciting match, and we'll be back with the starting lineup right after this timeout.
Watch Channel 25 next
week. St. Ed's going against Don DeRosa, a junior from Highland Regional. And it's all on the line. They've got to lay it out here tonight. Really, the national championship, Brian, is really at stake.
I think so, Mike. It's not like anywhere else in the country we're going to have two teams this good wrestling. Both teams heavily favored to be state champs in their state again this year. Macko, only a sophomore, DeRosa Jr. A lot of pressure on young wrestlers here at the first match. And I think the pressure is really more on Highland because they have to win these first three matches if they're going to win this dual meet. There's a stalling warning for backing away. The coach of New Jersey, Ralph Ross, told me if there is a difference in the refereeing, it's in how fast they call stalling in Ohio.
Wants to tie up. Coming close to the minute mark left in the first period, still scoreless. Don DeRosa Jr. Well, that's a stalling warning now on both of them, Brian.
That's right, St. Ed's there. These boys both won both their matches this afternoon, both pinned against South Carolina, both won four-point decisions against Tennessee, so it's obviously going to be a close bout. DeRosa right now 8-1 for New Jersey. He was second in their big South Jersey Invitational Christmas tournament. Macko is 12-0, but most of that's been on their second team, or their green team, as they call it.
6 seconds, man.
And it's the clock.
36 seconds remaining in the first period, still scoreless.
Both these boys are very nervous, and you can see that by the way they're wrestling so cautious. They don't want to make the big mistake early.
Down to 20 seconds. Macko trying that shooting. Down to 10 seconds.
Coming to the end of a very inactive first period with no score. Second period action starts with Macko from St. Edward's in the top position, and that's DeRosa down in the bottom. No score yet. DeRosa appears to be the stronger of the two wrestlers, and he's just about out of there for the escape. And there it is. 1-0, DeRosa, New Jersey, Highland Regional High School, the Tartans, Mike. Looking for that carry.
Nice counter by Macko.
Nacko's older brother Jimmy wrestled for Padua several years ago, and of course his father George, a fine coach at St. Anthony's in Parma. Jackie was a city CYO champ from that high school, from that elementary school. There's a stalemate call.
Macko seems to be more comfortable on his feet, Brian, as a sophomore. He likes to pin from that position.
Right, he's like a lot of St. Ed's wrestlers. They're very good on their feet.
Almost, almost.
That wasn't a very good shot by the New Jersey boy, but he recovered quickly. Shot with his arms out. Looking for the ankle there.
What is that height advantage? Two-point takedown.
That gives Macko a 2-1 leader right there with the spiral.
39 seconds left in the second period, and Macko takes the lead, 2-1.
I tell you, it's great to see these young wrestlers and take this pressure so well. I can remember Jack Macko working out at the Brooklyn Y, 8-9-year-old, and now 10th grader wrestling with all the pressure in the world here.
They're going to try and stack him.
In the second period, it's going to end. Macko in the lead, 2-1. There's Jackie Macko's mother watching the action.
And we start the third period. Macko's leading it 2-1. And what he'd like to do is just get an escape. He can stay on his feet in wrestling from that position because, as we mentioned earlier, he's more comfortable there. Whoa, going from the cradle.
You'll watch these New Jersey boys on the mat. They just eliminated riding time this year in New Jersey, so they're tremendous mat wrestlers, and they're great with that cradle. He almost had Macko at the out of bounds there. I think he's going to be trying it again.
There, he's going to have to do it again. Half a minute gone.
Looking for a reversal here.
Not yet.
He's working his way back, though.
Minute left.
Hitting the far ankle now. Now he'll pull him in.
He pulls it in. He's got it. Not yet. No points awarded. That one hand you see. The bandage still to DeRose of Highland. 43 seconds. They just don't want to get a stalemate called at this point. 36 seconds. He's got it. That makes it 4-1. Good 2 points, Brian.
Sophomore Jackie Macko. This would give Ed's a terrific leg up on this stalemate.
16 seconds.
Let me tell you this, Mike. Joe Melchiori is the finest wrestler in the Highland Regional time. He's a two-time world AAU champion. And there he's in with a duck under. And right to the fall position almost. This Melchiori, as a sophomore, was state champ with a 32-0 record. He's undefeated this year, 10-0 again. Outstanding wrestler. Chris Kennedy from St. Ed's, only a sophomore.
That's got to be an awful lot of wrestler to go against as a sophomore. Last
last year, Kennedy was on the freshman team. This year he's 6-3 at the varsity.
He was a 30-0 freshman record. This Melchiori has so far in two matches against South Carolina and Tennessee hasn't got out of the first period. He's pinned both of them in the first period. He's still got a minute to go in this period here.
And as you watch this match, that's what they mean by total domination.
In with the cradle.
What a fight Kennedy's putting up.
I should say.
44 seconds left, first period. Now if he locks that far leg, he's gonna...
He's got it right there. It's close, 30 seconds to go. There's the fall. 1 minute and 30 seconds for Joe Melchiori. That's the longest he's gone in this tournament. Three falls all in a minute and a half or less.
This is how it's done. This is the way a cradle's supposed to be on. Let's look at it again.
We're at 112 pounds, Dave Carlin, the sophomore from St. Ed's, versus Ron Hadvani from Highland Regional. And there's a takedown for Hadvani in the first 5 seconds. These lightweights for New Jersey are very impressive, Mike.
Senior coming in 30-5 over the last 2 years, with a 10-0 this year, 20-5 last year.
This Hadvani is a transfer from Camden Catholic in New Jersey. He's 10-0 this year, won the Big South Jersey tournament.
Ryan, a stalling warning was called on Anthony because of the way he held that leg. Now,
he didn't work his way up, and that's what you got to do. You got to work your way up to the head and start working for the fall.
What I'm leading to is the riding advantage they used to have. They just changed this year. You can't ride. And I think maybe they're still used to that philosophy, and you got to tie the guy up and start riding him.
Right, they're used to getting points for that, and of course, in Ohio or in New Jersey this year, that just doesn't happen. Remember Dave Carlin from last year, Mike? He was the leadoff wrestler against Midwest City and got the quick fall that got Eds off to that big victory. But he's wrestling a boy 2.5 years older than he is with a lot of experience, so it's going to be tough for him. Ed Vanny now really working for that fall in the far edge of the mat there. Carlin was just penalized there for crawling off the mat. So Hadvani now has a 3-0 lead. He's got to do something up there.
Coming up to a half a minute left, first period.
Lifting him and bringing him to the mat. Carlin getting up again.
What you've got to say of the wrestlers you've seen so far from Highland, they all go after the fall.
They've been aggressive. 15 seconds here. Ron Hadvani, the senior from New Jersey, leading 3-0 over Dave Carlin, sophomore from St. Ed's, who came into this match with a 10-2 record. And the first period will end with that 3-0 lead. Second period action starts with Carlin in the top position, but it's not going to be for long. A nice roll by Hadvani. And he's got the Peterson. He's got to get... Got to give back points there for that to be ruled a reversal in Ohio. Still no control. Hadvani with that Peterson, but in Ohio you have to get back criteria before you're allowed to get the reversal. Now he's going to get it.
Now he's got the reversal. Not yet. 2 points. He's got it.
This Hadvani's a very strong 12. And Carlin with the reversal right back.
No points given yet, though. They're staying. Hadvani still has the advantage.
I don't quite see how here.
I don't either. Not with a half in.
Looks like the near leg is what he's saying.
If the near leg is being held really by Hadvani, I think he wants it there. 40 seconds to go, second period. It's a 5-0 score. Ron Hadvani from Highland, the senior, is leading it.
15 seconds. He's not going to get any points unless he gets that back leg out. Advantage still with Highland. Second period, he got a one-point escape, so that makes it 5-1 at the end of two.
Ed Benny starts in that top position. You notice this time he worked right to the head.
Another point escape.
That makes it 5-2 here.
Of course, Carlin is used to working with class wrestlers. He used to work out with Greg Alinsky, two-time state champion.
That's not a bad place to start. And he was kind of a protege of Greg Alinsky's last year.
Both these boys had two falls in previous matches during this quad. Capable of pinning. We're down a minute 18 to go in the match, 5-2. Highland leading it. I'm wondering if Coach Ralph Ross from Highland banked on a pin from half inning.
I think he just expected a decision. I think where he didn't expect to lose, though, was at 98 pounds. I think he expected a decision there also.
Inside a minute to go, third period. Got the lead.
Carlin's been in that leg several times. He hasn't been able to finish the move. Hat Finn's superior strength has been the difference. There's another stalemate.
Down to 42 seconds. Again, Ed Bainey tries to go in for the two. Boy, what great control. Now it's 7-2.
I'm really impressed with Ron Hat Bainey. Hat Bainey was just penalized there for an unnecessarily rough crossface, which I think was there. He kind of slammed into it, especially since Carlin had been bleeding from the nose earlier in the match.
And he's going for that cradle again. Nice counter by Carlin, gets away, gets a point. That makes it 7-3.
7-4, Mike, with that penalty point. Carlin in for the takedown again.
Well, now he needs a great three-point move here, but he's only got 4 seconds in which to do it.
Looks like Ron Hatbenny's gonna give Highland a 9-3 team lead right now as they take a big six-point advantage over St. Ed's. Now, Jeff Bubba Strauss from St. Ed's against Mike Lamb. And Mike, these are old enemies, as it were. They wrestled twice in that old exchange program between New Jersey and Ohio when they were 11 and 12. They split then. But there's Bubba right now, and he's in with a takedown. That's 2-0, and he's looked tough all day.
Well, he's pumped up, isn't he?
And there's the escape. It makes it 2-1. Both boys are sophomores, both outstanding wrestlers, and there's Lamb. That makes it 3-2. And this Lamb is such a tall 119 that he's hard to wrestle with when you're on the bottom. Those legs, he came down from 145 pounds.